Hello students, in last video we saw how to calculate the equivalent weight of acids, okay, base, then element, then ion, along with the what we have the salts also. Now come to we have the percentage composition, okay, percentage composition we have the formula, mass percentage of any element equal to what, mass of that element divided with the molar mass into 100, okay. What is this formula? Let us go for the one example. Here we have the example. So first what here, molar mass of water is there. Okay, molar mass of water already we know 18 grams. So now in this 18 grams, I want to know how much percentage of hydrogen is there, how much percentage of oxygen is there. To know that we have the mass percentage of an element. This is a percentage of composition. Okay, now let us see. Total molar mass of water 18. Now if I ask what is the mass percentage of hydrogen, means here we have the formula what, mass of that element, means I am asking about the now hydrogen. So mass of hydrogen how much, we have the 2, okay, here we have mass of hydrogen how much, we have 1, how many hydrogens are there, 2, so 2 into 1 divide with the what, molar mass. So molar mass of water how much, we have 18, into formula we are asking the percentage, means into 100. So how much here now, how much percentage of hydrogen is there? We have the 11%. Now, mass percentage of oxygen. So, oxygen how much percentage is there? So, you know very well, in H2O we have only one oxygen. That is, in oxygen atomic weight how much? We have the 16. Divide with the what? 18. Why? Because means the formula is what? Molar mass into 100. In the formula we have the percentage mean 100. So, if you go for the total how much we have? 88%. So mass percentage of oxygen how much? 88%. If you here add together what happened, we are getting the 99, means if you go for exactly we are getting the 100, means in the 100% how much percentage of us hydrogen is there, how much percentage of oxygen is there, that we can come to know by using the what, percentage composition. Okay, now come to see the example 2. Now molecular mass of ethanol, here ethanol formula is what, C2H5OH. Now if you see the molecular mass 46, how means here we have the two carbons, for one carbon how much we have the atomic mass, 12, plus here how many hydrogens are there, we have the 5, this is H5, here we have the one more hydrogen, total number of hydrogen how many are, 6, so atomic mass of hydrogen how much, 1, plus here how many oxygens are there, we have only 1, atomic mass of oxygen how much, we have 16. So if you add all together we are getting the molar mass how much, we are getting the 46. Now so in this, now I ask how much percentage of hydrogen, how much percentage of carbon, how much percentage of oxygen is there, means now you can calculate by using the what, percentage composition. Now if I ask how much percentage of carbon is there, means what's the formula, mass of carbon, we are asking the carbon, so you have to take the mass of carbon divided with the molar mass of ethanol, that is how much here we already calculate, 46 into 100, this is the formula. If you go for the simplification, now mass percentage of carbon how much, we have the 52.1%. next if I ask mass percentage of hydrogen in that, why, because means already we have the here hydrogen. Now what is the formula here, mass of hydrogen, why, because means I ask the hydrogen divided with the what, molar mass, that is how much we already calculate, 46 into 100. Now if you simplify how much we have, 13% of hydrogen is there. Next what we have, which element we have, oxygen. Now next mass percentage of oxygen mean mass of oxygen divided with the 46, that is the molar mass of ethanol, into 100. Now so total how much here, now 16 by 46 into 100 means how much we have, 34.78%. means if you see now here total, this is the total percentage, this is the oxygen, and this is what, 52.1 for what we calculate, for the carbon, okay, 52.1 for 1% for the carbon, and hydrogen we have 13%. Now if you add all together we are getting the almost near 99.88%, means it's almost you can consider as a 100, okay. Why? Because means we are taking the mass of oxygen and hydrogen, we are taking the nearly 16, okay, we have some values are there, we are not taking the exactly. So now here what happened, total percentage how much, 100. So in this 100, this is the carbon percentage, this is the hydrogen, and this is the what, we have the oxygen, okay. Now So you can do the problem, refer the question number 11 in the textbook, okay, based on this concept. Next, if you see information from the percentage composition, okay. Now already we come to know how to calculate the percentage, okay. Now what is the use of, what type of information you are going to get from the percentage composition? So then let us read now. If the mass percentage of various elements present in a compound is known, its empirical formula can be determined, okay. Now if you know the mass percentage, you can calculate the empirical formula. Now let us discuss what is the empirical formula. Now molecular formula can be determined further if the molar masses is known. Now let us discuss clearly first what is empirical formula, what is the molecular formula. So before going to know exact definition of these two, now let us go for the example, okay. First I will go for the examples. Here we have some molecules, okay. This column indicate the molecular formula and this column indicate the what, empirical formula, okay. For example, we have the molecular formula of a compound P4O10. Now if you see the empirical formula, how much we have P2O5. For H2O, what, molecular formula, empirical formula same. For N2O4, if you see here, this is we have the molecular formula. If you go for the empirical formula, NO2. Here we have the molecular formula C10H22, empirical formula what, C5H11. Now here we have the another molecule C6H18O3. Here empirical formula C2H6O. Now C5H12O, molecular formula, empirical formula is same. Now if you see here difference between these two, what I am doing, I am going to do the simplification, okay. If you see here P4O10 means 2 2s are 2 5s are, okay. Here there is no variation. Now if you go for N2O4, what happened, 2 1s are 2 2s are. Now you are getting the NO2. Now if you hear what happened, 2 5s are 2 11. So you are getting the C5H11. Now in this case, 3 1s are 3 6s are 3 2s are. You are getting the C2H6O. Means empirical formula is the simplest formula. Okay. Molecular formula is what? Actual formula. Okay. Now let us see the definition. Okay. Empirical formula is what? Empirical formula represents the simplest whole number ratio of various atoms present in a compound, okay. Now what you are doing here, you are seeing the simplest whole number ratio in a ratio, what are the atoms are present, you are seeing the what, simplest whole number ratio, okay. Now come to, if you see the molecular formula is what, molecular formula shows the exact number of different types of atoms present in a molecule of compound, means exact number, how many atoms are there. For example, I told now H2O or P4O10 means exact how many atoms are there. We have the P4O10 means we have here 4 phosphorus atoms are there and 10 oxygen atoms are there. So from the molecular formula you can come to know exact number of atoms present in a molecule. Now if you see here we have the one note, that is what note, the empirical formula is the simplest formula and the molecular formula is the true formula, okay. So if you see here, this empirical formula is the simplest formula. Why? Because means you are going for the simplest whole number ratio. But what true formula is what? Molecular formula. So this the molecular formula is what? Is a true formula. This is the what, empirical formula means simplest formula. Now you should be remember, for H2O, both a molecular formula and empirical formula is same. In this case also, here what happens? C5H12O, C5H12O. For both these cases, molecular and empirical formula are same, okay. This is about the word percentage of composition. So from the percentage of composition we can calculate the empirical formula. Once you know the empirical formula, we can come to know the molecular formula. Next we have the how to if you know the percentage composition, you can come to know the empirical formula. For this, how to calculate the empirical formula, we have the some steps that I will discuss in the next video.